Virginia in the home white against DeJuan Blair. Jim Burr threw the ball in the air, working with Tim Higgins and Jamie Lucky, and we're underway.
Jay Miller's pick goes. Minimum.
Should point out immediately, it is very warm inside this building tonight. It was up in the 70s outside here today, uncharacteristically warm for this time of the year, and it is hot inside this building. Here's Ruoff, who's made 82 threes this year. And Alexander pulls it out to Nichols. The last couple of years, one of the best in the country, the assist to turnover ratio.
Two guard front out top, and Alexander gets into the high-low. He can also drive it from that spot.
And they can take advantage of mismatches. Nice hands. Benjamin.
Alexander was on the sideline. So it'll be Pittsburgh ball. Huge student section here to watch the 175th meeting. Pitt is the opponent most played in the history of West Virginia basketball. The Panthers have won the last four, including a dramatic meeting earlier this year. Young almost went into the backcourt and threw it straight up in the air to avoid the violation. Ronald Ramon hit a shot at the buzzer at the Peterson Events Center to give Pittsburgh the win against West Virginia back in early February. Neither team has scored yet. And here's Ruoff leading a break for West Virginia.
Got to settle down just a little bit.
Yeah, this has been sloppy on top of sloppy, and uncharacteristic for LaVance Fields to turn it over.
Everybody in a hurry. This reads tough, I think.
Well,
we got a piece. He used to be tough.
This is where he's tough. He hits the shot clock.
He had to have a piece. Come on.
Well, he didn't argue. Apparently just shot it wide of the entire backcourt. Jamie Dixon is fifth season as head coach at Pittsburgh. They've won at least 20 every year. If they win tonight, it would be their 10th league win, and it would be the seventh straight year that Pittsburgh has won 20 games or more overall and 10 or more in the league. They'd be the only team that could make that claim.
It's great to see the tape, and we'll see what Alexander can do.
Benjamin got his own miss. He was a star in their win Saturday at Syracuse, scored 17 points.
This is unbelievable.
They're just picking it up in a bad spot and being weak with it.
There you go. The old-fashioned pull-up by Nichols.
Darris Nichols, the lefty senior, averaging 11 points per game, but he's averaged only 7 over the last 6. They'd like him to pick it back up here down the stretch.
And you know that West Virginia, Sean, wants to try to get down the floor as quickly as they can, see if they can get something before Pitt sets up their half-court defense.
Oh, great pump and nothing.
And you really have to stay down on that shot fake by Sam Young. He uses an exaggerated shot fake, and when he does, he always looks to drive.
Sean Blair called for the foul. Bob Huggins back at his alma mater. 610 career wins. And now in 22 of his 26 seasons as a college head coach, he's won 20 games or more.
It looks like he's getting soft with that little flower on his lapel. Even Digger wouldn't wear that.
He's so relaxed, though. Different guy.
Back home in West Virginia, Alexander to miss and Young the rebound. Bob Huggins was born here in Morgantown, lived here until he was 9 years old, played collegiately here, was a team captain and a great student. And LaVance Fields, the tough runner, going left, shooting with the right, back off the glass.
He is really back, I think. Watching tape, he turns the corner now, something he didn't do a few weeks ago. Much more aggressive getting to the 10.
And he's such a smart player. To have him out on the floor just frees up everybody else to do their jobs without worrying about bringing the ball up and initiating.
Butler the miss, and the rebound run down by Ronald Ramon, the hero of the first meeting of the season between these two teams. Young bumped several times, and finally Jim Burr had seen enough and called Smolligan for his first foul.
And no way Smolligan can stay with him, but this is just that little hesitation and then the little blow by, and you can see they have the open middle, lifting people, deploying correctly, and no help.
And Deshaun Butler staying with his man Ramon, not wanting to get burned at the three-point line. That opened it up.
Good hands by Ruoff to knock it out of bounds. 3.5 minutes played. Each team is 1 for 4 from the floor, and each team has turned it over 3 times. We're tied at 2.
You know, Jay, it's not the great defense you used to see at Cincinnati with Huggins, but they keep it down field goal-wise. They're aggressive.
Nichols, Ruoff open for 3. Young, a good rebound in traffic, He averages 6.5 rebounds per game to go with his 18 points. LaVance Fields from the free throw line. He missed 12 games with a broken bone in his foot. And as you say, Bill, he looks to be just about 100% now. That left foot no longer an issue.
Fresh, and he gives him a little rotation, too.
And just a smart play. Nichols has to pick him up higher and stop the ball around the top of the key.
A screen down. Not afraid to shoot the long ones.
It's Nichols from deep. That's a three in the lead for West Virginia. Darius Nichols has all five for the Mountaineers. Blair in transition.
Well, that just kills a coach, you know. Oh, goodness. Huggy a little excited, putting the arms out in frustration. You've got to get back, see the ball, particularly after you ring the bell.
Well, Smalligan's got to run back and really get into him. He cannot allow an easy run up the floor. You've got to be right with your man. You can't celebrate a basket. You got to run back.
They got to make these. This is his shot, but he hasn't been hitting them lately. Look at the rebound by Joe Alexander.
Alexander following up the Smalligan miss. Smalligan has not scored in their last four games. He was 0 for 5 from the floor Saturday against Connecticut when Coach Huggins was hoping he could pull Hashim Fabit away from the basket by making some shots. And a foul on the way up. Benjamin reached in to stop the progress of Alexander. Will be at the free throw line after a timeout. Alexander off a career best game Saturday as the Mountaineers ahead by one here tonight. He would have gone on to the national championship game. It might have been one of the big reasons why Rich Rodriguez left his coach to go to Michigan. And of course on the basketball court earlier this year, Ramon's jumper at the buzzer handed West Virginia University a tough loss on the basketball court.
And what a difficult way to lose. Wellington Smith helps off on the drive, leaves a three-point shooter wide open, and the only way you can lose was to give up an open three.
And of all guys, Ronald Ramon.
Exactly.
One out of two at the line for Alexander, who's an 81% free throw shooter this year. He was 63% for his career entering this year, so much improved in that area.
Now feels much more active off the ball. Nice hesitation. Ooh, I thought he was going to jam that. Young at heart.
Well, he's so good with those shot fakes. That was just a little hesitation shot fake. And really all he did was lift his eyebrows up. And Alexander was up in the air.
They put a lot of pressure on him because they're so good outside. They move great without the ball. Nice screen to get Alexander to the box. Roll off. Supplied. The pick.
Alexander, such a good athlete. But he has to stay down on the defensive end. The scouting report on Sam Young is he likes to use shot fakes. He barely just lifted up. He still had his dribble.
And how about this? Just a little screen. The attack at the rim, fumbling the basketball, but you're so wide open. Alexander able to complete it.
And one of the problems, you got to stay every time you want to take away a basket cut. You have to stay on the ball side of that cut. Pittsburgh didn't do it on that occasion.
Wow. Just we talked about how improved Alexander is at the line. He's one out of three tonight. The foul on Ramon was his first. It's a two-point lead for West Virginia, nearly 6 minutes in. Gilbert Brown knew that shot was off, went spiritedly after the rebound. Too much vigor as he's called for the foul. He was terrific in their win Saturday against Syracuse with 12 points off the bench and 5 rebounds in 21 minutes. A key three late during that rally.
And another three also right after going
one. He had two down the stretch.
And so you were at the game 0 for 17 going in. And the one thing Jamie Dixon said to us before the game was they wanted him to keep shooting it in practice, and eventually it would turn out. It certainly did for Pitt.
Year third in the Big East, and that's his 158th career three, seventh all time at West Virginia for the junior from Spring Hill, Florida.
Now one of the ways he got open, he set a screen first. When you set a screen first, you're oftentimes going to get open second.
Gilbert Brown the miss, Nichols the quick head ahead, Ruoff again, and a great one-handed rebound in traffic by the very athletic Sam Young.
Boy, Fields does look good. He's pushing the ball up the court. He's active. He's got great bounce, which I don't think he's had much of up until the last week. Take a look here at Alex Ruoff. Watch, he's going to set a little screen right here, and then he's going to come out off of a flare screen right afterwards. Sets the screen, then he's gone. Picks off Ronald Ramon there and sets his feet quickly, and he has got deep range, but the key was setting the screen first.
And asking Huggins about it, he said, boy, he's great without the ball. He said, if he shoots well, he's great without the ball.
Alan Nichols was his first. Fields missed the free throw. Vance Fields is 8 out of 8 from the free throw line against Syracuse Saturday, a game in which Pittsburgh made their last 5 shots from the floor in their last 8 free throws, traveling the call as they scored the last 9 points of that game at Syracuse and finished the game on an 18-2 run for the improbable win. Super Tuesday tomorrow night. Coverage begins with Big Ten action. 7 Eastern, Purdue meets Ohio State. Then at 9 to the SEC, Arkansas and Ole Miss. Super Tuesday presented by KFC on ESPN.
You know, we're now into must-win territory. People use the term, it seems like, all year long. But Ohio State has to win that game. They have to. And I think Ole Miss has to beat Arkansas.
Oh. High dribble, but Fields kept possession of it. Young, wow, that was pretty. He soared over Alexander to score.
I'll tell you, the defense has been very good for West Virginia, except off the dribble.
Yeah.
They've been able to penetrate and break them down.
They're not a great defensive team in guarding the ball, and they're a little weak in help side, but they really get after you with pressure.
And Wellington Smith getting more and more time, really stepping up his game. He can put it on the deck, bite you outside. Not a good handle here by Alexander.
And Brown in transition scores despite the defense of Darius Nichols. So Pittsburgh takes the lead. And Bob Huggins is going to go to the bench for John Flowers. It's a 6-0 run for Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh is very courageous in throwing the ball ahead, not afraid to make a mistake.
Alexander drives on Young. Nicely done by the junior from Mount Airy, Maryland, out of Hargrave Military Academy.
A screen and pop. That's what he does well. Terrific at putting it on the deck and great elevation.
Well, that's a good look to him. After that curl off the top, that really clears out the defense and gives him an opportunity at the high post. Well, they're just isolating and taking these guys one-on-one. You got to stay down on closeouts. That's way too easy.
We're going to not foul on the checkout. Not a good play. I think Nichols gets it, Sean.
It is. And that. Well, you want to pick all the teams for the NCAA tournament. Now you want to pick the all-time top 25 in our IBM countdown.
Yes.
Would you just like to be a super delegate as well and pick the president and get the whole thing over with?
Yeah, we wouldn't have to listen to it anymore.
It was all about the bounce early on for Pitt. Now they're running their bumps and shape-ups.
Well, that's good because we haven't had some good bump and shape up talk in a while here on Big Monday. Our last Big Monday of the season, Ramon turned the corner and then lost it off his leg.
Well, he did everything but lost the balance as he got near the rim.
A little bit too much pounding it into the wood. I think you want to try to move the ball a little bit more before you drive this West Virginia defense.
6th turnover now for Pittsburgh. Joe Mazzulla into the game, the backup point guard, with Nichols on the bench with 2 fouls. Here's Wellington Smith short with a jump hook of his first shot of the game. And Gilbert Brown the push for the Panthers.
Transition defense has not been good for West Virginia thus far.
Nice again. He just raises the eyebrows. They jump, go airborne.
And it's so exaggerated, and they go for it every time.
Young a miss, and then a foul on Tyrell Biggs on the rebounding action. As John Flowers snared the rebound. Bob Huggins said it's been a very good first year. He has been frustrated by their inability to win the close ones. They do have wins on their resume over Marquette and Syracuse. And an RPI of 41, which at this time of the year, particularly depending on how the conference tournament shakeout, really has you right on the bubble.
No question. And in addition to Marquette and Syracuse, their best win would be against DePaul. Now, they lost a game to Tennessee by 2. They lost in overtime to Oklahoma. Barely lost to Pitt and barely lost to Georgetown. Easily could have won both of those games.
Seton Hall, another good win.
Yeah, it is now. Not when you coach. Ruoff the bucket.
They are patient on that offensive end, and they're cutting and screening impeccable. They end up shaping up. This is a very good slip team, too. Ruoff, of course, a guy you think of beating the outside. He's gotten better putting it on the deck. The drop step. A little kiss by Alex.
And taking the smaller Ronald Ramon down into the post. And his ability to shoot from deep really sets up some cuts, whether they be back cuts or flex cuts.
Ronald Ramon to the bench with two fouls. So each team has a starting guard on the bench. Ramon, the shooting guard for the Panthers, who was the point guard and fared very well in that role when Fields was injured for those 12 games. And Darris Nichols, the point guard for West Virginia on their bench.
It's like a little 1-3-1 here. Matching up out of it.
They didn't see it, really. And they got a foul on the shot. They give him two shots. That's that athleticism. They were underneath the rim there, undetected. Great diagonal look against that 1-3-1, Jay.
And he is a big-time athlete, just slipping behind.
38-inch vertical for Gilbert Brown, the redshirt freshman from Harrisburg.
Thrust into having to play this year with Mike Cook out for the season. LaVance Fields missing a significant part of the season. Playing out of necessity. It's been one of the reasons that Pittsburgh has struggled a bit lately with their rebounding is the fact they really can't go at each other full blast in practice like they usually do.
And they're playing smaller with the injury to Cook. They're playing a three-guard lineup most of the time with Benjamin, Fields, and Ramon, all 6'2 or smaller.
And of course, Blair's not a monster, even though he's got the great wingspan, but he does play bigger.
Mike Cook was hurt in their win over Duke at Madison Square Garden in overtime. Benjamin, a block of Butler, out of bounds to West Virginia. Of course, that was an emotional loss of Cook. Jamie Dixon was fighting back tears after the game when he found out Cook would miss the rest of the year. So disappointed for the young man.
See, Butler can't adjust that shot. He's got to go straight up and go into that contact to get a foul.
You know, I remember you telling me John Thompson III was really concerned talking to you about Cook as well. It was somebody in the family got hurt, and it was such a traumatic time for everybody.
I went into the gym to watch Georgetown practice the first day after that happened. They were getting ready to play Memphis, and the first thing that John Thompson III said is, "How is Mike Cook?" And talked about what a great kid he is and how sick he was to see him go down. Mm.
Transfer from East Carolina. They hope he'll be able to come back for another year. They're going to appeal for what would be a sixth year, essentially. He was averaging 10.5 points per game. Then in the very next game, their first loss of the season at Dayton, Fields went down. So you have to give Pittsburgh a lot of credit. Without two key starters for much of the year, they have really held it together and then some.
Man, how about up in Syracuse, Sean, when he called that timeout, "We're not going to lose. We may lose, but we're not going to quit," Jamie said to his guys. And you know, insurmountable to most people. Would you agree when you're watching that game? You thought it was over,
it looked,
right?
Like it was game over. Jamie Dixon said, "We're going to fight all the way to the end." They did, and they won it. He has foul concerns now as Gilbert Brown takes the seat with two fouls. Ramon also on the bench with two. So it's Fields, Biggs, Benjamin, Blair, and Brad Wanamaker, a freshman in for the first time, number 22.
Oh, too deep. How about that entry pass by the Biggs? The big fella outside. Look at those wide shoulders.
Yeah. Boy, the strength to get that shot up when he got fouled pretty hard on the way up.
They're playing this 1-3-1, and it gives him matchup problems. He just went right after Wellington Smith and got into him.
No beef from Wellington as he was called for his second foul.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, pick up the check on that one.
It's the last big Monday. We have to get all this junk out of the way before we pack it in for another year. It's one of the great images, one of the lasting images of that Pitt-West Virginia game earlier this year is when Smith left his man. Ramon hit the winning shot. He left Ramon to double on a drive. The shot of Wellington Smith with his hands on the top of his head was an image that was replayed many times.
2-3 zone now by Pittsburgh.
Now this is dangerous. Ooh, get to the spots. Right here, he's tough at dispersing the basketball. Plus, he can make the shot. Small again.
Flowers, strong move, and he's fouled. Flowers is a freshman, 6'7", 195, out of Waldorf, Maryland. He had 9 points at Connecticut Saturday in their loss. He averages 5 points per game.
Pretty good without the ball, like all of them. A snapback, the button hook to the box.
His mom, Pam Kelly Flowers, three-time All-American at Louisiana Tech. And John could use the help from the rim. He's a 37% free throw shooter for the year. More substitutes for Pittsburgh. You saw Blair went out, and Gary McGee, number 52, is in, a 6'10 freshman. 8.5 to go, first half. 1 out of 2 at the line. And it's a three-point lead.
Against this 1-3-1, they still have to attack the baseline. Get the ball down on the baseline where they're vulnerable.
I think they switched back to the man, though, Jay, on this trip. Beginning of it, anyhow.
No, they're just switching back and forth. They're still in it. They're just, they're, what they're doing is matching up out of it.
Shot clock at 6. Fields tried to rifle it underneath, and McGee lost it over the end line.
Tell you, they're going to have to take their medium jumper right now. Everybody exchanging bodies. They're lost. Just screen in. You're going to get a good look.
I think against defenses that switch and this 1-3-1, which is essentially matching up and switching, you run your man stuff against it. Distort it.
Missoula, he had a career-high 15 points in their first meeting against Pitt this year. Flowers short from the corner. Fields off with a three-point try. McGee the offensive rebound. Whoa, boy, that looked like a pretty good block from behind from Flowers, but Tim Higgins has it as a foul on Alex Ruoff. And why wouldn't Randy Moss take less? Whoa, to stay in New England. Everybody wants to be in New England. McGee banked in the first free throw.
38.
Well, go along with the second one as well. Alexander the rebound.
Well, that's not his strength, and he's been contributing lately, Jamie said. Rebound.
Missoula, sophomore out of Johnston, Rhode Island. Now Alexander fouled on the arm by Sam Young. And that's the first on Sam. The Panthers are over the limit. And a long way to go here in the first half, 7:13 remaining.
Joe Alexander, very good with the turnaround jumper, likes to post, and he can go over either shoulder, but I think that's a pretty good shot to force him into, especially turning to that baseline side and fading away a bit. He can't foul on jump shots.
He turns, and you mentioned his free throw shooting, how it improved. He is struggling today from 60 to 80.
He's heading back towards 60 rapidly. Now 2 out of 5 tonight. He did not have a good first game this year against Pitt. As a matter of fact, he's already surpassed his point total from the first meeting. He had 5 points in the loss at Pittsburgh on February 7th. He blocked that shot attempt. Missoula 1-on-2. Ruoff runs into an open 3. That rattled out.
And what a great look in transition by Missoula to find Ruoff. That's a great shot in transition.
And a bad gamble. A tough look.
Good save by Missoula. Boy, this looks like a turnover waiting to happen, but West Virginia keeps it alive. It started with a terrific offensive rebound by Cam Thurlman just off the bench. He's in the right place again. Couldn't corral it and then committed the foul. First on Thurlman, a redshirt freshman out of Portsmouth, Ohio, has been battling injuries all year long.
Just brings hard work and energy off the bench, works hard every day in practice, and if anything, Bob Huggins will honor that.
So Benjamin's at the line for a 1-and-1. It was the 9th team foul against West Virginia, so that'll be the last 1-and-1. It'll be 2 the rest of the way. Benjamin the miss. Both teams struggling at the line. Benjamin 73% for the year. He's another guy much improved. He came into this year at 60% for his career.
You know, both clubs are fortunate. They have point guards that are backups. And, you know, occasionally they play them together. You know, Missoula plays with Nichols, and, of course, Fields and Ronald Ramon. Pretty good combination. Then throw Benjamin into the mix. Good front by Young.
Biggs doing a nice job of helping out. He's not as particularly concerned about Thurman out on the perimeter.
Oops, Missoula bounced it off his foot out of bounds.
Thurlman got hurt on that play, Sean.
And he's limping toward the bench after the sixth turnover by West Virginia. John Flowers will come back in.
The official's not exactly sure how play stopped because they didn't blow the whistle. The horn blew and everybody stopped.
That's what you have a home clock for, or clock caretaker.
Bill, do you get the sense we talked to Jamie Dixon before the game? Young, and deflected by Butler. And Jim Burr says, no, I'm going to double dribble now, but I think Tim Higgins is going to come in and say the original ball was deflected. They're going to confirm.
Well, they called a walk earlier when a West Virginia player lost the ball and grabbed it again.
Now let's see if he got the, see, he got a little piece early, but he still had it in his hand when he went up. That's a tough one. You know what I mean? It's stopped here, and then you continue up.
But how can it be a double dribble?
Well, if it wasn't, if he's saying it's not touched, though. You know what I mean? He jumped in the air and threw it up on his own is what they're calling it.
So it was just a really late whistle?
Yeah, I think so.
Alexander the bucket. He has 10 off the career high. 32 Saturday.
Got to get into the lane with the bounce. That's when they've been effective.
Got in the lane, but didn't get it up on the rim. Benjamin in the right place.
Well, not a good shot, but that's what happens. You get offensive rebounding position.
Still need to make a few passes before they attack off the dribble.
Good point.
But offensive rebounds are going to be available. This is an improved rebounding team for West Virginia. They were a very poor rebounding team the last few years.
What a ball fake.
Ruoff rattled in a three. Timeout, Pittsburgh. 9 points for Alex Ruoff and a 6-point lead for West Virginia. There's that gun. You know he did it.
James,
I don't think he's done
it
yet tonight. This is the largest lead for either team. A 6-point edge for the Mountaineers. Now under 5 minutes to go, first half. Sean McDonough, Jay Billis, Bill Raftery, delighted to have you with us for the final Big Monday of this season.
Nice cut after the screen by Biggs. That's making up for it.
Benjamin from Fields. Beautifully executed out of the timeout called by Jamie Dixon.
You got to get more pressure on the ball to try to take away vision.
There's Nichols back in to play the point for West Virginia now with two fouls. And Butler was out of bounds. He got the pass. One of the most storied rivalries in college basketball lives on Saturday night. Tyler Hansbrough and the now number one Tar Heels play in front of the Cameron Crazies when they take on Duke. And DeMarcus Nelson and the Blue Devils get a series sweep against their arch rival Saturday primetime, presented by DirecTV on ESPN at 9 Eastern Time.
And all healthy, too. Should be a great one. Lawson back. All the Duke guys are healthy.
Are you trying to stir it up between the two coaches again here, the stuff about injuries and whether or not people make them public or talk about them too much?
You don't have to stir it up between those guys.
And it's early enough for you for your nocturnal proclivities. 9 o'clock, you'll be finished by 11.
I'll be a bed, a sound asleep, resting up. Missoula called for the foul. Fields at the line. 74% for the year after that 8-for-8 Saturday. Preseason, honorable mention, all Big East.
And he was playing so well before he got injured at Dayton.
He hit one of the biggest shots of the year in college basketball. The step back three in overtime to beat Duke at Madison Square Garden with under 5 seconds to go. Pittsburgh won that game 65-64.
2-3 zone now by Pittsburgh. Got to get the ball into the middle.
This is where they're tough. Nice. Oh, was that pretty? Nice going, coach. Terrific look by Alexander.
And Alexander, because he can hit that turnaround jump shot from that range, is particularly dangerous.
He found Flowers for the score. Fields called for an offensive foul.
That was tough. Pretty good penetration, not a bad recovery. And your point earlier about moving the ball, you can always get that late, but how about that high-low, Jake?
Getting the ball into the middle and dumping it down. It's always nice to get flowers on senior day, isn't it?
I'm sure it's a big disappointment. I mean, that mascot's a big deal here in the state of West Virginia. I'm sure there are several people who grow up dreaming about being the mascot.
Well, you could be late when they turn you down as the orange.
Still in the 2-3 zone.
Nichols.
Nice.
Unbelievable.
Well, you have to stay down on these fakes. Both sides have lifted up too easily.
We got Ramon in the air. Ramon wants to be careful not to commit his third foul. Ramon hasn't taken a shot tonight.
Pretty pass and just a nice cut. Wow, Biggs has done some really nice things out there. And of course, Young sending it in.
Six points for Sam Young. The West Virginia lead 4, under 3 minutes to go in the first half.
They do a nice job overloading and popping out to the same side. How about the ability to knock him down? Nichols.
He's hot tonight. Was 10 out of 31 from the floor over the last 4 games. But he's come out firing and has 10 points tonight. Gilbert Brown missed a putback. And finally a foul called as Tyrell Biggs went back up.
We're just getting pounded on the offensive glass. This last possession. You can see the ball, like, nice little shot fake, but you just can't lift up that easy and let him go past you. And you can see underneath, Sam Young, just a quick post from the other side of the floor. Nothing fancy, just beat his man into the lane. You got to jump to the ball and meet him right in the middle of the lane and deny him that post position.
Biggs missed the first free throw. 63.5% for the season. Keith Benjamin back in for Ronald Ramon. They don't want him to get the third foul with 2:15 to go in the half.
And so many turnovers in this first half for Pittsburgh. They've got 9 turnovers thus far, still 2:15 to go in the half.
They nearly have 12 average on the season and counted that 10 for Huggies guys. And they're up with 7 as well. It's been sloppy, not really a smooth sailing for either. Even his flower looks like it's wilting.
In the heat. It's very warm in here. More than 70 degrees in Morgantown here today. It was, well, what a catch by Nichols. And then Butler's there and he's fouled. It was a strange sight to drive up to this building for a game in early March and see the students lined up around the Coliseum in shorts and t-shirts. But that's how warm it was in the low 70s here today.
And selling suntan lotion at the look at these kids, look a little tired, huh?
They weren't impressed by that back screen lob?
No. Well, they run some nice stuff, don't they? Cleared that backside, and of course that opens up the rebound, and you go to the lob guy, and all of a sudden it opens the glass.
Gilbert Brown with 3 fouls, so he's gonna go out.
Just overloading one side, and Joe Alexander coming up to set the back pick, and it was a great catch, and then a nice follow inside by Deshaun Butler.
Well, there's a sophomore from Newark, New Jersey, out of Bloomfield Tech. 64% for the year from the line. He made both. He played the full 40 minutes Saturday at UConn. They had a road game, as did Pittsburgh. They were up at Syracuse, so a short turnaround Saturday to Monday and a very warm night. We'll see if fatigue looks like it's an issue later on.
Well, Butler gets by his guys, and he's a nice read
by Ruoff, but then he did not connect with Flowers, and Brad Wanamaker got it back for Pitt.
Pretty pass
into Biggs. Too strong with the left hand, and the rebound by Butler, who averages 6 boards a game.
Well, they've had so many easy opportunities inside, haven't been able to get them to go down.
Timeout. Bob Huggins, 1:23 to go. And his team up by 8, the largest lead of the night. And we remind you, tomorrow night is Super Tuesday as ESPN presents another great college basketball doubleheader. Big Ten action at 7 Eastern time. Purdue ranked number 15 in the rankings just out tonight against Ohio State, a team that could really use a win on the bubble. And then at 9 Eastern, action from the SEC. Jay Brapp's 2 bubble teams there in Arkansas and Ole Miss at 9. Super Tuesday presented by KFC. And Pittsburgh, we don't think they're on the bubble. We think they're in. Just a matter of seeding and just a matter of trying to finish as high as six. That's the best they can do in the Big East with one game left after tonight, and that's against DePaul at home.
What's amazing about them is their resiliency this year with all those injuries and just keeping the ship afloat. And you mentioned Arkansas in that promo. Beat Mississippi State, who's a heck of a basketball team, amongst others, Baylor as well.
It's amazing people aren't talking about Mississippi State more. That's such great talent. Really have had some good wins. They started out 5-5, but have been great in SEC play.
Look where they're getting the ball. Everything but.
Too many people going over for that shot block, and that opened up the offensive glass for a guard to get in there.
Well, great timeout. You got it to the box.
The basket by Ruoff has given West Virginia a 10-point lead. Under a minute to go now in the first half.
Silly foul here. Butler.
Alexander setting screen after screen, getting into the low post. You screen first, you've got an opportunity, but they had three guys going after that shot block, and that opened up the offensive glass for Ruoff.
Colin Butler, his first. Two shots at the line for Sam Young.
Well, Sam Young has had a great season, but one thing he could do a better job of is rebounding. And he played 32 minutes against Cincinnati, didn't grab a rebound.
That is incredible when you think of it, his ability to elevate.
Averages 6.5 rebounds per game. Made both to make it an 8-point game. West Virginia with three players in double figures already. Alexander, Nichols with 10, and Ruoff has 11.
A gift two-shot foul. And that gives Pittsburgh, if they rebound, a chance.
And Alexander got the rebound, and then he got hit.
I think it may have been Fields from the rear. It's just a guess. A lot of guys around them.
And they gave it to Young. They did. Young second.
Alexander went straight up and used both hands. So it would have been near impossible for him to get any kind of over-the-back call. He's such a good leaper off 2 feet.
Alexander at the free throw line. Well, he's been terrific shooting the ball lately. Alexander, the last three games, 29 for 46 from the floor, and he's 4 out of 7 from the floor tonight. Took 24 shots to score those 32 points against Connecticut Saturday, but made 14 of them.
It's interesting the way the ball comes out to the right. He's missed some free throws to the right.
Just a couple seconds difference on the shot clock. That means that Fields and Pittsburgh can take it all the way down to the end and still have time for a tip-in without giving West Virginia an opportunity.
Because the dribble drive, too, presents that you go to help, opens up that opportunity at the 10.
One thing you don't want to do here is foul by getting into a screen too hard.
Fields.
Too early.
With three, West Virginia has time. Ruoff still has plenty of time. But he traveled as he went to pass off to Alexander. I thought he actually walked back in the backcourt when he first got the ball, but got away with it.
To avoid the charge? Yeah, right. Good point.
Well, I thought that Fields took that shot way too early. That gave West Virginia a great opportunity to extend this lead.
1.7 seconds to go. Inbound to Young from just inside half court.
There's the gun you were worried about, by the way.
It works. I don't know if that was the new mascot or the old one. Alexander, Ruoff, and Nichols all in double figures in the first half for West Virginia. We're at halftime here in Morgantown. The homestanding Mountaineers lead 40-30. Here's Reese Davis in the studio with the UPS halftime report.